you're going to open up the Techno CNC interface. We're not running Mastercam in here, we're running Techno. And it, you know, what you've done in the computer is you've taken your graphic CAD file, Robbie, and you've converted it to G code, just numbers. This thing could only read numbers. Okay? This tracks this way and Y, this way is X, up and down is Z. Jog speed is inches per minute of travel. So if I want to move this thing around in the Y direction, see how slow that's going? It is going 35.7 inches per minute. If I turn that up, it's now traveling at 200 inches per minute. Okay? This is Z. It's all the way up, Z down, and then back and forth in X. Okay? If I want to jog it by certain incremental steps, I could put it on step instead. You know, and this is 20 thou right there. So now it's on step, and if I hit it, it's going to move over 20 thousandths at a time. So if you're really trying to just step over 5 thousandths at a time, I put on step, and I bring it down to 5 thousandths. So that's continuous versus step, just like in math class. Discrete and continuous, okay? So here's the front and back cover of my book. Actually, I have another one right here. And then here's a stack of printer paper. And I think I'm going to go to about 45 thousandths. So I'm going to just take a stack of paper here. Put it inside my book. And remember, every sheet is 5 thousandths of an inch. Right, again, I want to make sure I'm in inches. I zero it out. And then with my digital caliper, I'm going to see how thick I am right here. And I'm 0.432. So I'm 432 thousandths, and I want to go to 0.45. How many sheets of paper I need? Yeah, 3 or 4 sheets of paper. And you could do the laser engrave for the step or after the step, it doesn't matter which order. The file that I'm running is on the E drive. None of these computers are networked. I go to Schwartz, and then under Schwartz I have every project. My project, this is a notebook, and under a notebook I have 3 different files. It's that one right there. I hit OK. I pre-process it. I want to make sure I preview it. And I can see, it's hard to tell, but that red is saying I'm in the lower left corner and I'm cutting out all of these parts. And I have multiple depths of cuts. Okay? So I exit that. Then what I want to do is, because I know this bit is going to go into the lower left corner, I have to bring it into that lower left corner. Okay? So if I try and move it right now, it's saying the controller is not enabled. That's because I pushed that red button in. I got to release that. Hit yes, and it'll be able to move it. And then I gotta set that at the lower left-hand corner. I'm gonna travel pretty fast on my jog speed till I get close. And again, this is an 1/8-inch flat-end mill. I'm gonna get kind of close. And then once I get, you know, within an inch or so, I'm gonna turn that jog speed way down, like 10 inches per minute, okay? And then I'm gonna set the center of that bit on my lower left-hand corner, okay? Now that I have, I'm saying that's my origin. Just like on my computer, I said that's the origin. I need to let this computer know it's my origin. So I'm gonna say zero, all, and now I'm telling it that's where my coordinates are, okay? And then it's ready to go. Make sure you have your glasses on. That everything's clear on the table, underneath the table, there's nothing gonna get caught. Usually you're gonna have the vac on. I'll leave the vac off. And then the other thing you wanna be ready to do too is this is an emergency shutoff. So if you're going too fast or that thing's on its way to the other side of the table, just hit this emergency red button and it'll stop your run. So I'm gonna hit start. Thank you. then if I'm all done, I'm gonna get back to a fast jog speed. I'm gonna bring it up out of the way. And then I shouldn't have to really undo too much of my jig. I might have to take off one block. And then there's my notebook. Let's run through the cover, the pages in the back cover. Maybe a little bit of sanding to clean it up. And then you're just gonna take one of these plastic binding combs. And then put the fingers through there. And there's your book. You put the whole thing together and keep it that way until you do the laser engraving. You can do, at any point, you can do the laser engraving. Everybody get on CNC router. So again, it's my file. You go Schwartz, notebook, and then it's the final one that runs it. Where's the bit start?
Lower left hand corner.
Any questions on anything? Okay, there it is.